Very good morning, students. Welcome to another lecture on microprocessor and microcontrollers. Today we are going to discuss about the I2C, that is inter integrated circuit. As we have already seen that it is a synchronous communication. So coming to this, in this chapter we are going to discuss about the circuit of this I2C and the control registers. Coming to the basics of I2C. The I2C bus was introduced by Philips company, and it is a half duplex serial communication system, and that means half duplex in sense both transmission and reception takes place during the with the same port, though there will be a common ground, it will not be considered. See here, so the I2C buses uses only two bidirectional lines, serial, that is serial data and serial clock. See here, the serial clock is being generated by the master itself. Okay, serial clock and serial data, these are the two signal lines that should be that are connected or that are interfaced between the microprocessor and the controller. It is often called as a two wire interface, one for the communication and one for the ground. Thus, I2C provides full functionality of bus while using a fewer lines than SPI. That means here the connectivity is less, or the number of lines or the number of wires used between this module is very less when compared to SPI. Here the data transfer on the bus takes place between master and slave. See here, you can master and slave. Okay, and we can see that each slave has a unique address with which is usually a 7-bit. Here it operates in a 7-bit, it operates in a 10-bit also, either 7-bit long or it's a 10-bit long. Okay, next one, the master starts the transfer, provides a clock, addresses a particular slave, manages the transfer, and finally terminates it. That means here the clock for the slave is provided by the master itself. See here, the master transfers, start the transfer, provides the clock, address a particular slave. See here, it is addressing a particular slave, and it is providing the clock, and it is starting the transfer, and also manages the transfer, and finally terminate that particular slave. See here, there may be more than one master. The very most important point to be remembered in this session, that is the I2C bus contains more than one master, that means multiple masters and multiple slaves on the bus, although only one can be controlled at a time. Though we have more than one master, but one master can be controlled at a time, and multiple slaves will be there. For example, see here, I have considered as example that here only one master and I have taken two slaves here. See, so here the data is this master is providing a clock pulse to both these two slaves. See, clock line that is provided to the master. Here master as well as slaves, both the slaves. Okay, so the electronic interface to the I2C is slows like this, and for a master here there are two slaves, and a full featured slave has same hardware as a master. See, this is a full featured slave which is having this hardware as same as the master, but most of the simplex cannot drive the clock line. Okay, clock line source. Okay, so on the other hand, we have a slave that must be in a, that must be able to drive the serial data. So it also must be, this slave also must be in a manner that it also should drive the serial data, and digital outputs are normally driven for both their binary values, either it may be VSS or VCC, that is VSS in sense VSS is nothing but that is a 0, or VCC in sense that is nothing but logic 1. And a pull-up resistor here, these pull-up resistors keep the lines at VCC when none of the devices are active. That means when none of the devices are active, then this pull-up lines makes the VCC equals to 1, and the devices must be therefore, the devices must therefore have open drain. See here, this is an n-channel MOS. So whenever no device is working, then this will be active. Pull-up resistor keeps the line VCC at VCC, and everything is off, then this NPN transistor will be in on position, which makes this one as a open circuit. That means making this value as a logic 0. See here, the pull-up resistor holds the line at VCC when there is no activity. That means no activity has been done, so both the clock data and both the clock and data line is high at a single NMOSFET is turned on. This is turned on, it makes the pull down, this makes it into a pull down, and makes the given logic as a 0. I repeat once again. So this pull-up transistor keeps, if any activity is being done, then this pull-up transistor may be in on position and the activity is going to be done. If no activity is being done, that means no data transfer is being done, then this n-channel MOSFET pull down the resistor and makes or connect this the two lines to the ground. That means it makes it as a logic 0. So coming to the I2C protocol, we have can see here how the data is been transmitted. Initially, for example, if data is been transmitted from slave to master, see here, I am slave to master, that means the data is present in slave and the master is accepting that data or reading that data. In order to make this possible, how the protocol should be there? That means we need to give a start bit along with the 7 or 10 address bits, as I have told you previously. So this is a master one, so the master has to send a start bit, yes, I am ready to accept the data, and I am giving you or I am assigning you these 10 bits for address frame. And here this read write bit acts as that I am ready to read or write the data. So here acknowledging, it shows that I am ready for accepting. Then it gives a data frame which is of 8 bits, and after receiving 8 bits it sends an acknowledgement, and after receiving another 8 bits it also sends the another acknowledgement, and the finally the stop bit is going to be entered. As I have so told you previously that the data word should be starts, suppose while calculating word that I have told you that start bit number of data bits along with stop bits. See here, here we are activating SCL means serial clock and STA means serial data. Here we are activating the serial clock is here right now. So whenever this is a start bit, that means we are making our master in a slave mode, that's why we are giving a low active low signal here. Okay, when we are giving a active low signal here, whenever the data is being started, that means the start bit sent and this address frame is sent to this data, and the data or which is present in the serial data bus or the slave data slave will be transmitted periodically. So here the clock signal starts, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, I have told you that either 7 bits or 10 bits. Now it is transmitting 7 bits of data, that is address transmitted by the master. This it is transmitting the address, and here we are reading the data, that means it is an active high signal, that's why it is in active high. So we are reading data from the slave, that means it is an active high signal. Here A represents the acknowledgement. So here A represents the acknowledgement by the slave. We are sending the data to the, or we are acknowledging, we are sending an acknowledgement signal to the slave that I am ready to access the data. See here, here in the slaves, in the slave mode, here it is the clock source, okay, and it is the serial data which is to be transmitted, which is transferred from the slave to the master. See here, D7, D6, D5, D4, D3, D2, D1 and D0. It is an 8-bit data transmitted to the slave. This is D7 bit is nothing but okay, here also it is sending an acknowledgement signal, that means I have sent the data, please check your data. Here after sending all this one, it is going to send the stop bit also. And coming to the I2C block diagram, here this is a clock selection mode and this is a baud rate selection. Okay, coming to the clock selection mode, clock selection unit, UCSS, Universal Communication Interface Clock Selection Source. Okay, clock selection source. See, these three are internal clocks and this one is an external clock. Based on this clock, we are going to transmit or divide the number of signals or the number of data bits. And UCMST selects whether it is a master mode or a slave mode. And from this, see here, UCSCL, serial clock data will be transmitted. Here we have a UCSCLA, means a slave selection. What type of slave should be selected? Here it is a 10-bit slave is being selected. Slave address and time shift, transmit shift registers and transmit buffer register, which is a predefined one. Okay, based on this selection, slave address selection, how many bits has to be transmitted, and by this will be sent to the here, and the data which is already present in this transmit buffer register will be transmitted to the transmit shift register. After on the triggering of the clock pulse, the data is to be transmitted. Okay, SDA, transmit serial data is been transmitted. Okay, coming to the here, I2C state machine. State machines shows the status of the register. So here this is our receiver section, receiver buffer register and receiver shift register. Okay, and this is our own address register, which is predefined, and based up here it is an enable signal. Okay, and coming to the control register of I2C protocol, here as I have so told you that it is an 8-bit, so here bit 0 shows that this is an asynchronous mode enable. So what type of data should be sent? If it is 0, then it shows for the goes for the asynchronous mode, and if it is 1, then it goes for the synchronous mode, as we have previously discussed about the synchronous and asynchronous modes. And bit 1 and 2 shows the USCA mode, universal serial communication interfacing mode. So based on the bit values, 00 3 pin SPI is used, and based on 01 4 pin SPI, and it is an active. 10 means it is also a 4 pin SPI with an active. If it is 11, then it goes for I2C mode. And bit 3, master mode select. So whether we, if it is 0, then we are going to go for the slave mode. If and if its value is 1, then we are going for master mode. And bit 4 is not used here. And bit 5 is UCMN, that is multi master environmental slave. As I have told you that here we have both many number of masters. There may be more than one master, but one can control at a time. See here, based on that one, multi master environmental select. If it is 0, then we are going for a single master, and if it is 1, we are going for a multiple master environment. And coming to the 6th bit, UCSLA10, that means slave address mode is selected. As I have See here, UCSCLA. Okay, slave address mode has been selected here. That means if it is a 0, we are going to go for 7-bit address mode, and if its value is 1, we are going for 10-bit. As I have already told you that it may be a 7-bit or 10-bit long. 10-bit long. And coming to the last one, UAC10, that means own address mode select. So if it is 0, then it selects 7-bit, and if it's 1, it selects the 10-bit address line. And this is all for your I2C protocol. Thank you.